And I am the Bob that flaps in the night.
But no more. Because you died.
Okay. Whatever, John Hood got what he needed done. He got us to the boss.
Skip.
I got us to the boss, that's all that matters. Whee! Dog! Ooh. Ooh.
I do really like this game. It scared me when it first came out.
I will crush you like
Arrgh! What year did this game come out?
2000 and something.
Good guess.
2007.
Whee!
Jesus Christ, man. Even I tried to at least not get hit that much.
Yeah,
no. And I was dicking around.
Yeah.
Basically, we just gotta dodge the shots. It's usually easier to just pure run.
No, I'm gonna strafe, damn it. God gave me the ability to run and shoot at the same time. I will use it. Right, Zelda Breath of the Wild? That game is probably gonna suck so hard.
I'm hoping it'll be good.
It's gonna run on the Switch.
Which has good games coming out on it. It's not gonna be a power console. But...
No, but it's all. But Bob, when you say that, you know, the best way to play it is in the handheld version as opposed to being on the big screen TV, that's a problem. Yeah, you have to play it on the handheld version to have no hiccups and all that. It's like, what the fuck? No!
Yeah, that's just a head scratcher where you wonder how.
What the fuck were you thinking?
I couldn't figure out which way it was gonna go. What the? Honestly.
I want to see you be brave.
Good.
Say what you want to say. And let the words come out.
I wouldn't even.
Wee.
Throw it out.
I want it Bob's way. Not really.
Tell me, Bob.
Does it really have to be that way? What the fuck? Fuck, man. Oh, wow. You lucked out so hard. You dove right into it, man. Like, you... Oh, I would have laughed if that got you. Not even gonna lie. Stop moving! You don't need to keep moving, damn it!
Up there it is. 2009.
All right. I figured it was 2009.
Yeah, tail end of high school. Well, for me and Mike.
For some of us.
Yeah, it was a few years
Not ago. Like you youngins.
Yeah, you don't remember what it was like for, you know, digital dial-up.
Oh, no, I had that. Couldn't be on the phone while my mom was on the computer.
Yeah!
Then you had to throw shit at people.
Whee! Dodge, damn it!
What is a dodge?
I don't know, but I'm gonna quote Josh. Just dodge.
Just dodge. You're not doing it.
What are you doing?
I mean, you know, Darksiders do. You need to kill this guy. No, he's too powerful. No, you need to do it so you can get the loot he drops.
Now I'm gonna beat a woman! Get over here!
Bobman beats women? Okay.
Well, I mean, no, you gotta spray.
Oh, it's that kind of thing, is it?
I'll spray all over her.
What are you doing, Batman? Her plant looks like a vagina.
I'm gonna blow my load.
All over.
You know, I didn't think that for this plant, but for the plant she had in a... What was it,
Could be a vagina, it could also be a whatchamacallit.
Who's the guy that...
Batman and Robin, that was it. Batman and Robin had poison ivy. In that movie, yeah, I thought that plant looked like a vagina.
Who was, Oh, I'm trying to think.
Of?
Who's that artist that drew... A picture of pit of flowers that looks suspiciously like vaginas. Because they mentioned him in Family Guy a very long time ago.
Yeah, back when Family Guy had good ideas.
Hey! That's fair. I mean, I don't want it to go the route of The Simpsons, but it's already gone the route of The Simpsons.
You have to quit sooner, I think.
Nah.
No, it's still going.
It's still going. It has some... weird premises for episodes, but it's just sort of...
Talk to me, baby!
I think the last recent episode I saw was Peter was pimping out Quagmire.
I don't know. I miss Bob's Burgers.
That got weird after a while.
I imagine.
Most of these shows do, it seems.
But, I mean, you know...
They have a good start, but then they either keep it going too long, like Family Guy or The Simpsons, or they go dark with it too early.
Do you want to watch Luke Cage? No, Mike told me not to.
I told you not to, so you can watch the other ones, just because it makes it a little easier for you. I mean, it's not going to ruin it for you. I'm not going to sit here and say it would be the worst thing in the world, but...
Well, we saw the first episode.
Yeah, we did.
Nah, everyone wants to wear the crown. Nah. Now, what I hate more than a thief is a goddamn liar. Oh, see, now I can hit you like a man.
Thanks, Cottonmouth. You should have been the villain for the entire first season.
Should have been.
But it's okay. We had Shades, right?
No.
Oh, well, then, never mind.
It's okay. We'll hire some new writers. They'll retcon it.
Well, they retconned him anyway.
Damn it, Mike Man! Or Mike the Boy Wonder. Yeah, I could see you being Robin to Bob. He makes you
anything
wear,
but Batgirl.
He makes you wear the skimpy Batman. The Robin outfit with the yellow...
The green banana hammock?
Yeah, there you go. That's exactly what you're running around, Mike, in.
That was the condition for, when I was a senior in high school. There was a freshman who basically went around acting like he was my sidekick, so I said, you know what, yeah, senior costume day, Mike just come in as Batman. You might just get to be Robin. I was like, I love those guys. He's like, yeah, but you have to be green banana hammock, Robin. But why? Because I'm in charge.
Because...
And you stole my prom date.
Okay, so there you go. There was the real reason.
That hadn't happened yet.
Oh! Foreshadowing.
Yeah, season 3 is gonna be nuts.
Bob's a time traveler.
Then how'd you get to prom, Bob, if you didn't have a date?
Well, someone else asked me. The rule was that you could only go into the prom if you had a date.
But he was... Was he in the same grade as you?
No. He was a freshman.
Oh, then your date just didn't care enough.
And I asked her late. It was a whole thing. High school was weird.
High school sucks. Everyone from high
school...
Yeah,
anime makes it look cool, like you're gonna get superpowers or something.
No, it's because the Japanese work environment makes it... Remember that?
Yes, we watched that.
That was actually educational, and Mike can tell you the entire time I'm just screaming, why the fuck would I ever want to work there? Why the fuck would I ever want to live there?
What, was this a video you saw?
Yeah.
Yeah, I believe it was Gaijin Goomba.
It was Gaijin Goomba and the anime guy. It was the anime guy that talked about the whole, you know, work to kill yourself. And I was like,
work yourself.
And I was like, Jesus Christ, why the hell would you ever want to live in Japan that way then? It doesn't even sound like they value you either. It sounds like, yeah, the way it sounded, like they didn't even value your work. They just wanted you to be there for no reason.
No, it's that, I thought it was that the people put too much pressure on themselves.
Yeah, and the company doesn't actually give a shit.
Yeah, they don't want you to work as hard as they do, but you just work yourself to death because you're a stupid jobber.
Or your senpai,
there's, you know, this, yeah, the senpai.
The senpai-kohai system where your senpai, you know, they had to deal with it, so they're gonna make you go through with it.
Yeah, no, I used to work 38,000 hours a week. That's not possible.
Remember we heard that,
though? It is with the time
traveler.
The
guy said he worked 3... Wait, how much was
3,000 hours
a year.
A year, yeah.
Which meant he was doing more than 80 hours a week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That guy needs a hobby.
Yeah. No, he's dead.
Oh.
Yeah. Died of a heart attack.
Yeah, most people who do that will die of a heart attack, or they'll die of something. They'll die of a heart attack, they'll die of raging boner-itis.
Raging
no, that's if you eat that mushroom or get bitten by that spider.
Listen, if you're not afraid of guns and being stabbed, then I'm afraid of you, mate. Grade A under A. Love that guy. I still love that. It's like, I can't tell the difference between this spider and the freaking
boner death one.
So I'm just going to treat them all like they can kill me with a horrible erection.
Oh, we are.
Yeah, we can go straight to the end game.
Or, and hear me out on this.
Or, we go straight to the end game.
I mean...
How do you do the take them down?
I don't know.
You have to be crouching and then hit triangle.
Ah! You grabbed his dick.
Crouch with right trigger.
Okay. Now this is the way to play the game. I mean,
yeah,
I just...
Bob Man's advice. 2 seconds too late. Put the condom on! It's too late! No, you fool!
She's already having the baby! Put the condom on! where were you 9 months ago?
I know, right?
It's like, what in Cabo? I was having fun.
I was doing
flashback to him at Cabo wearing a sombrero drinking out of a huge Stein glass. It was a really confusing trip to Cabo.
It was great, though. I met this girl. We really hit it off, but then she wanted too much of a commitment. And I was like, baby, Bobman, don't do that.
You told her you were Bobman?
Bobman can't stop talking in the third person anymore.
Look.
I didn't... Like Whisper!
You told her you were Bobman?
I didn't mean to. And
with that blackmail, she was able to arrange a wedding.
I hate my son so much. His name's Blamian.
See what I did there?
See what I did there?
He's the reason I don't have fun anymore.
I can't go out gallivanting anymore at night, beating up rogue galleries. All my rogues galleries are like, what happened to you, man? I'm like, I had a kid. They're like, oh, what?
Ooh, we can get a special achievement up here.
Guy looks, he's like, why don't you just bring him along?
Shut up!
I thought there had to be more of them for that special achievement to work.
Maybe there's more inside. It's supposed to be a party.
Yeah.
Oh, this is great! Oh, you're so cool! I love you! Bobman does not approve of his fans.
They just show up right at the very end, like all the fans who are going to watch this series.
Ah! Okay.
Okay, new Josh.
You mean old Josh.
Yeah, I was about to say. Old Josh. There you go.
Alrighty.
Okay. Wait, I thought the trophy to beat them all up?
Beat them all up.
Okay, I was about to say, I thought it was the opposite.
X and square is throw, I forget which buttons they are, but there is a way to do the instant takedown.
Yeah, we only need one Josh on this channel.
And he got canceled for it.
Yeah! I'm trying to be less toxic, I really am. I mean,
there is no cure for my toxicity.
I mean, I haven't told Bob to shut up, or I haven't gone out. I haven't attacked him like we used to, remember?
Yeah.
When we started out, I have not once attacked Bob.
Remember that, Bob? Remember?
Remember Bob?
Remember Bob? Remember the drive home in the rain?
Yeah, remember Bob? Remember the time I drove you home in the snowstorm when you found the Mexican damn channel?
It's different every time I turn that station on. Jesus. Public radio.
I was confused as hell when you did that.
Enjoy the ring!
The suffering!
The three rings of marriage.
The engagement ring, the wedding ring, and the suffering!
Well, I mean, I figured the suffering only came in when you were both, like, 40 and you wanted to try new things,
Bob,
so you started tying each other
here
up.
There you go. You can finish it out. You brought us in.
Did you just fucking say that when you turn 40, you're going to try S&M with your wife?
No,
she's
not. Why the hell would I wait that long?
I don't know, man. You don't seem like the type of guy who's got a kink. You seem like the type of guy who, like, you know, you want to cuddle afterwards. Legitly want to cuddle.
Are you excited, Batman? I am. There's a bulge in my pants. Can't you tell?
I've seen so many things. Erections.
Yeah. Allow me to activate my true power. Chop, chop.
I'm trying to figure out who that was. Someone was here.
Mark Hamill? Clayface? Barbara Streisand?
Moen was here? I don't know.
Mary Tyler Moore? Oh, no, she's not.
Bring it on! I'm not afraid!
I don't know, you backed
I love how no matter how far back you are, you still get fucked up.
I know, right?
Yeah, it's a bomb. Don't play with bombs, kids.
I mean, yeah, it's a bomb, but...
Did he just blow you through the door?
No, he blew me off that door and back again.
I love that Hobbit book.
Best...
We could probably make two movies out of that. You shut up.
Three movies if we really work at it.
I remember doing this and thinking, this is okay.
That made it cool. This part here makes it cool.
The nonchalant takedowns, like, yeah. Thanks, Bruce Lee.
How many times is he going to do that?
How does he even know they're there? Oh, he threw the Muppet.
He's Batman. He built a thing in his brain to allow him to predict when, you know, which one was coming to attack him.
Oh, wow, it's that guy with the one eye.
Oh, no, he died earlier.
Oh, okay.
Beating up Bane. Like, he was the second body we found.
Nice. I'm Batman, by the way. This ends now. Mark Hamill. I'm the only surviving member of Star Wars left! I mean...
No, there's Harrison Ford.
Han Solo? I mean...
Han Solo's dead.
Chewbacca?
No, I meant just Harrison Ford in general.
No, I meant in the context of the movie. In the context of the movie, he's the only surviving one next to Chewbacca.
Yeah, but...
But I don't consider Chewbacca because when you think... Okay.
C-3PO?
I don't consider anyone who's not Harrison Ford, Carrie Fisher, or Luke Skywalker...
Which is interesting because they kind of, you know, they took a chance on some no-name actors when they were casting that.
Yeah, Mark Hamill became an amazing voice actor.
Then he got in a car accident. Then he came back and did the voice acting thing again.
Yep, and he's also still in Star Wars as probably Rey's either father or mentor. I hope she's his father.
Probably.
I'm sorry, I don't...
I hope she's his father.
Yep. I don't know. I just kind of feel like there's no point, like, no, she's Han Solo and Leia's daughter. It's like, why? Then wouldn't have Han and Leia been more emotional about that reunion?
Been happy as
yeah. Man. When in reality, they were just like, oh, okay.
Probably whatchamacallit.
Luke's daughter.
Luke's daughter.
It does make sense. Because why else? Because if...
That's why no one's happy to see her, because she's the daughter of Luke and Leia.
Well, to be fair, if we go by what they established...
That's why no one is ever happy to see her. Just, should have stopped at that kiss.
You know what's funny, though? The way they've set up that series, anyone... It's like, Anakin's bloodline is amazing at the Force, but apparently Anakin's son just became... Because remember how natural it came to him, the Force? Leia still had to train for it?
Yeah.
I mean, she's got latent abilities, but they weren't like Luke's abilities, you know? Like, he quickly adapted to the Force when Yoda was training him.
Yeah, but he also had to.
Yeah, which is why I'm stating he's probably got more...
Like, if they put a high pressure...
Midichlorians?
If they put a high-pressure situation on whatchamacallit, she'd be like, oh yeah, I can do this.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sure... You know, Rey being the Mary Sue that she is.
I'm also going to point out, she picked up Anakin's lightsaber, which technically shouldn't be there because Luke lost that when Darth Vader cut his hand off in the Cloud City and Luke had to make his own lightsaber. I'm just saying, inconsistent lore.
Yeah, but you know...
No, it finds you.
No, that's bullshit. It's not a keyblade. It is not a fucking keyblade, damn it!
They also suggested that,
it's a Zanpakuto.
It's actually Obi-Wan's,
Odion. You know, that guy who stood next to Merrick and didn't say much?
If it's Obi-Wan Kenobi's lightsaber, then it wouldn't be Anakin's.
Yeah, no.
And it remembers it remembers everything Darth Vader did.
Yeah, but I mean, probably not Darth Vader. Probably.
Yeah, it does. Remember
Anakin.
When they were showing the...
Yeah, no, what I'm saying is Vader and Anakin, while they are technically the same person, they are two different people in the contents of
the
lightsaber. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. I just think...
Yeah, just like your dog remembers you, and it also remembers that guy who gets mad at him every time it pees inside.
I miss my
different
dog.
People.
I miss my dog.
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like...
Stop that.
I don't know what they were thinking with that whole lightsaber thing. They're like, it has memories. I'm like, this is newish. This is some new bullshit right here.
That's why I think Whatchamacallit is just going to turn out that...
It remembers you. Makes it worse when you abandon it in the field after getting your hand cut off, doesn't it?
What is it? She grabs it. It remembers, I think, stuff as Anakin... for a little bit. Then it remembers Luke's adventure all the way up to Cloud City because that's when he last had it. And then it just is like, I'm Darth Vader! Also, who the fuck grabbed the helmet? I'm dead
Ewok? They were turning the helmets into drums, so...
Luke grabbed the helmet.
He did?
Yeah, when after he pulled it off of
he put it back onto his dad's body when he burned it. Yeah. So that's
the helmet would have survived the fire, maybe. But like I said, Ewoks were grabbing the helmets and using them as drums.
I don't know. I want Kylo Ren to either get
an insanely new overhaul, or I want his character gone.
Not that bad.
Kylo Ren?
It's not horrible.
He's not horrible. Yeah, but he's...
I mean, guy. I heard he was ripped.
But I... It's not, like, man, your friend's a liar, man. He's got... He's like a bit... He's like a bitch, man. He weighs like 30 pounds with wet clothes on.
I see what's in your mind. And it sucks!
Dude.
I wonder what's gonna happen in the new
That Batman. Fucking sucks. I love that skit. I don't know.
I go Batman.
Doesn't 8 come out this year?
8 comes out this year.
8 Man?
When's the Justice League movie supposed to come out?
I don't care.
Whenever they get the good idea to animate it.
Because you know what?
I know that was a bad thing, but I was just like, I don't care about DC at all.
Jason Momoa actually looks pretty interesting as whatchamacallit.
Aquaman?
Aquaman, yeah.
I don't know. I'm just like,
when's the next fucking Marvel movie?
Guardians of the Galaxy, May 2nd.
May 2nd? Okay.
Oh, I'm seeing that.
Yeah, I want to go see it.
I want to see that at the movie tavern. Remember that, Bob?
Yes, I do.
What, you wouldn't join me if we wanted to go to the movie tavern?
No, I would.
Okay, good. Because I would like to do that.
Member?
I members. Do you members?
I watched Civil War, the Avengers movie.
You mean the Captain America movie?
The Captain America movie.
Still haven't seen that.
I was like, the fuck?
I didn't want to see it, and I choose not to see it. I don't care if it's just going to be referenced from here on out.
Dude, I am telling you right now, two things. One, they don't go against each other as hard as they should.
Like in the comics?
In the comics, no.
See? Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, he went...
Creepy Joker.
Yeah, the Titan has mixed itself with the other stuff he had going on with him. That's his ribcage right there.
Yep.
No, it's oh my god, it's just fucking, the movie's ridiculous.
But we can wait to describe that in the next episode.
Do we want to, or do we just want to have a long one where we fight the boss?
I was gonna say we're just gonna have a long one and just end it.
Alright.
The boss fight's all that left until we...
If you can do this in one shot, go for it.
Yeah.
Should be able to, as long as my health doesn't carry over.
Which it probably will.
It won't be... Only way to beat me. You can't win without cheating.
I cheat the other way.
You wasted the antidote on yourself? Stupid
Wait,
man.
He doesn't even cure himself with that.
I mean, spoilers?
I guess, if we're going by Arkham Knight.
And Arkham City.
So the antidote was nothing.
Well, the antidote just kept him from changing. The thing itself is still kind of poison. Oh, I can upgrade the detonator.
Does that serve a purpose in the fight?
No.
Okay.
Unless he sets multiple ones down.
Oof.
Yeah, he hits hard.
Yeah. Dude, look at the final boss.
Look at his nails. He's like Wolverine nails. Wolverine's claws were nails.
Or the Asian woman from that one.
Anyway, you were talking about Civil War, because I didn't watch it for the sole fact that I was like, if I'm going to watch a Civil War, I want it to be like Civil War, you know, not just Captain America and all that. I want it to be the Marvel Cinema Universe taking up sides with each other and beating the holy shit out of each other.
I want you to know this right now.
They're probably holding off on that until they have more of the Marvel Universe back.
They're never going to get X-Men back unless they really cut a deal with Fox, like a really outrageous deal.
Oh, they're not going to get it back. Now,
if anything, they're just gonna have to buy them back one character at a time.
You know what's funny though? They got rid of the X-Men in the comics. They're now focusing on the Inhumans, the people that live on the moon.
Yeah. Well, now what I was gonna say is no. That movie, it has set up the stupidest reason for them to be fighting.
Oh dang, my nails.
Because Lex Luthor thought it would be cool.
I mean, that's how you get Batman versus Superman.
It might as well be fucking be. Because
they fight for no reason, they stop for no reason. This is the movie. Don't give him money.
Yeah, Wonder Woman just showed up.
Hello.
No backstory needed. Just Wonder Woman.
I mean, I think her movie comes out soon.
I don't know. I'm not going to watch it.
Yeah.
I might just to see what becomes of it.
I'm not a
DC. I don't know if I want to. I don't know if I want to pay movie price for it though.
I'll wait till it gets to Netflix, like I did with.
I'm not a DC fan, so I. The Superman movie, I would not watch again. Man of Steel, it was okay, but I'm like, I don't really want to watch this again.
Oh, yeah. I understand. Now, some of their movies are good. Sometimes they're just kind of...
preachy. Though. There is so much Jesus symbolism in that one.
The Nolan North Batman movies I'll watch.
Yeah. Those are fine.
Yeah.
Yep, good old Nolanverse.
Exactly. That Batman I liked. I don't know. Ever since Zack Snyder got in charge and he was like, yeah, that's why I did it to Superman. And I'm like, I don't care, but it wasn't an interesting movie.
Zack Snyder doesn't care.
Yeah, no.
I'm pretty sure he went online and said I could make a movie where Bruce Wayne gets raped in prison and it would still be my movie.
Why would anyone let him do it, though?
Because he can.
DC would let him?
Probably, I don't know.
Because he'd be like, it's my movie, let me do it.
People have made mistakes like that before. Like hiring David S. Goyer to do Blade Trinity. After doing the other Blade movies.
But Blade.
Yeah, Blade was okay.
You know what? I would like to see him return in some format, whether it's like the cinema universe or, you know...
just TV.
Well, you know, a lot of people talk about the fact that...
I think Blade and Luke Cage should be in Infinite. Or Luke Cage should definitely be in Marvel versus Capcom Infinite.
What I was saying is a lot of people forget that Blade is actually the reason why superhero movies got a resurgence to begin with.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, because they made it cool again.
There's always some motherfucker trying to skate uphill.
You know, after Batman and Robin.
Okay, now you two are gonna get together. He's like, you got the antidote? What? You're not getting together? No, don't you understand how this goes? I love the Nostalgic Critics review of that. Oh, man.
Oh, yeah. No, you don't understand. This is a movie. You need to fall in love at the end.
Batman. Isn't his whole thing... What is his superpower? He's just half vampire?
He's half vampire, so which I think it gives him super strength and speed.
He has vampire powers without their weakness to the sunlight.
Yeah, that's not how that works.
He had to inject himself with garlic or something just to keep the vampire thing from taking over?
I don't get that. That's not how that works, right? Two halves don't equal out. What am I trying to... two negatives don't cancel each other out, right? That's what I'm saying.
Usually not.
So, like...
ah, then the payback bullshit of this ending.
Like, yeah, you mean the fact that what he just
put
on there...
He should lose his fucking hand.
Whoopoo!
Yeah, you're right. He should have lost his hand. Or broken it.
Which it looks like he's broken his hand, but at the same time... they probably shouldn't have broken just his hand. It probably should have broke his hand and his arm.
Fucked his gauntlet up.
Yeah, that's gonna take some... that's gonna take some money to fix.
Wait, okay, so what were the reasons?
For
them fighting in Civil War?
They're fighting because a guy in, whatchamacallit, a guy in, you know when they had Ultron and attacking and destroying everything?
Yeah.
Well, his family got killed. So he spent his entire time getting revenge. He realized he couldn't kill them by attacking them head on. So he got them to attack each other and kill each other.
I can't kill you head on, but Jesus, man, am I going to make you kill each other.
Let me see. What do I got? I got a giant monster, a god, a super soldier, and a billionaire. I could maybe kill the billionaire. He's got magic armor. Okay, I can't kill him. So I'll have them kill each other. Except for I won't involve the green monster or this... fucking god.
Haven't decided what we want to do with our characters yet.
I'll just have the other two kill each other.
Isn't Thor and Hulk going to be in a movie? Isn't that Ragnarok?
Yeah, they're supposed to be in Ragnarok, but...
What is it supposed to be? Is it supposed to be based on that one storyline where Hulk shows up in Asgard and just starts wrecking shit?
I guess so. I'm not
That's
sure.
a movie I remember. Hulk versus Thor versus Hulk, or Hulk versus Thor, and he just shows up in Asgard.
I thought it was Odin went missing, and now Thor and Loki are now searching for him with the help of Doctor Strange.
That probably is going to have show up.
Guess what? They're going to have to establish that, because that was never established in Thor, that he knew that Loki was Odin.
Alive.
Yeah, remember? Because in the end of Thor 2...
He assumes he's dead.
So technically that means when Ragnarok starts up, he's got to find
out. Yeah, Doctor Strange is probably going to show up like halfway through the movie.
Yeah.
Because it's probably going to be at the beginning of the movie, he finds out that he's alive, and then...
Yeah, and then see Strange.
There. But, yeah, so he gets revenge on them, has them fight each other. But the reason why they keep going and keep fighting each other is because it turns out Bucky killed Tony's father and mother while he was under the effects of the Winter Soldier. And Cap explains to him very seriously, very earnestly, he should have spent the time to explain this entirely, but all he had to say was, hey, listen, the reason why he did this was because he was under the effect of Hydra, you shouldn't do this. And he responds with basically, yeah, no, fuck you. And then that's why the entire war is going to continue.
Wait, it's still going on?
Yeah. It's still going on, technically.
So, Cap and Marvel... Cap and Iron Man.
Iron Man now has control of the Avengers. He's... basically, everybody who sided with Cap was arrested. He let them all go as a show of good faith.
Iron Man?
Iron Man, yeah.
Yeah.
Because he doesn't agree with the government anymore. Or the UN. He said, fuck them. Even though he lost Black Widow, who is on his side. He lost a shit ton of people on his side, basically. Only a few people stayed, like Vision. Yeah, Vision.
Wait, Cap's side Vision, or Iron Man's side?
Iron Man's side. Iron Man only had the Vision and Spider-Man at the end of it, really. Because Black Widow left, and so did Black Panther. They both said, no, fuck it. Black Panther didn't do it because he realized that getting revenge was actually the stupidest thing he could do in his entire life. He's like, I've realized now that revenge is a bad thing. And the Sovovian guy is just like, yeah, till you actually get what you want. I'm good.
And Black Widow left, obviously, because...
She left because she realized that she's never going to be able to stop Captain America and Bucky. Because Captain America's never gonna fucking quit.
Also, Black Widow has a habit of disappearing.
Yeah.
Like, every time I see Hawkeye in a cartoon or a comic, he's looking for Black Widow.
Yeah. But then all of his side got arrested, so at the end of the movie, even though they had this whole fight and everything like that, you know, Iron Man's basically gonna, like, kick the shit out of Bucky. He's about to kill him. Cap basically knocks Tony Stark out. He and Bucky escape, and then Cap is, you know, Iron Man's just sitting there, motherfuckers, so on and so forth. Realizes maybe he made a mistake, so on and so forth. He gets a letter. Basically, Captain America's like, listen, dog, I understand you're going to keep doing this, but could you not keep doing this? That'd be real cool. That'd be awesome, but I know you're going to keep doing it, so it's okay. But, you know, I would like you not to. And
what?
He's like, I get that there's some bad things, there's bad blood between us, you know, but sometimes, you know, the darkness that rises up around the world.
No! They would meet in the freaking moonlit night and discuss and fight.
They might as well have, because that's exactly what, like, the story, like, plays it off as. And then,
So wait, Cap tells him he knows he's gonna
He knows he's gonna keep the Avengers. He's like, basically, he's like, look, I'm leaving the Avengers now. He's like... He's like, well, that's, you know, earlier in the movie, he's like, he told him basically that Captain America can't be in the Avengers anymore. And Cap was like, if it's Bucky or the Avengers, then I'm Team Bucky. And then he, like, walked out and he's like...
Doesn't Bucky still hate him?
No. He had, like, a 50-50 thing. When he's under the Winter Soldier, he hates him. But then when he's not, he's like, he's a good guy. He's a good guy.
Wait, so he's not, like, completely in control of himself?
Yeah, he has mental conditionings from both Hydra and the USSR. So, basically,
certain things will trigger him, and he will then just listen to whatever it is. Like, that's how the Serbian guy gets him to gets Bucky to escape, because he basically when he gets captured, he's sitting there and he's like, "Look, man, I'm gonna be peaceful. I'm not gonna do anything." And then the guy starts reading this book, and he's like, "Nah, man, nah, not today. Not. I'm gonna stop listening. How do I stop? Yeah, I gotta bite my ears off." He's like, he gets to the end of the paragraph, and the guy's, Bucky's like, "Yes, what do you want me to do?" He's like, "Escape." And he's like, "Okie dokie, bro!" And breaks out of the thing, and then fucking books it.
The Serbian guy sounds like an ass.
He is. And all he did was do it because his family died. And then,
wait, so he's the guy that set this all up?
He set it all up.
I just thought a random Serbian guy showed up and was like, yeah.
No, this was the Serbian guy. This Serbian guy knows exactly what's going on. The Sokovian, that's what it is. Sokovian. This Sokovian guy knows.
Yeah, Serbia's a real place.
Yeah. He knows exactly. He apparently knows about Bucky to such an extent that he was able to know his triggers. He knew that he killed whatchamacallit.
Tony's family.
Tony's family. And then, like, at the end of it, the Black Panther takes Bucky, and he's like, "We're gonna put you in frozen containment area." And he's like, Will I remember it?" He's like, "I guess. I don't know. Do you remember it every other time you were frozen?" And he's like, "Yeah, do." He's like, "Okay, then you're gonna remember it. Go to bed."
I just solved your quest. I solved your answer. Deal with it.
The Captain America him are talking. He's like, "I'm sorry, Cap. I don't know what I was doing." He's like, "I know exactly what you were doing. You were under control." And he's like, "Yes, I was under control." So then, basically, Tony's like, fine. He lets all the people who sided with him, so he let out Hawkeye, Ant-Man, whatchamacallit, who else? Like, whoever, like, you saw in the video who was fighting, he let them out.
After he was getting his shit rocked by Bucky and Cap?
Yeah,
that's
all
they ever showed in the trailers was him getting his shit rocked.
Oh, he loses that fight.
Yeah, the one where it's 2-on-2 where he's like, bam, 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 and double teaming him.
Yeah.
I was like, dude, he's getting his ass whooped.
He loses that fight. He only is able to, he wins by cheating at one point, which I'm going to tell you right now, I don't care how good his fucking computer is, it's not going to predict, it might predict, but it's not going to predict Captain America's fight style, because that's what he does. He's like, he's sitting there, he's like, the computer's like, "Maybe you want to apologize. Maybe you want to just stop this. Maybe this." He's like, "God damn it, analyze his fighting style. Figure out his movements." And she's like, "Most likely he's going to do this." So he literally knows how to counter all of his boxing punches, stops it, and then knocks him the fuck out.
Technically, you can in boxing. Boxing's actually
you could.
Rigorous thing. You know exactly what they have. All you technically got are jabs and hooks.
But then we're also getting into thing the time that while Captain America is throwing the punch or preparing the next one, the computer has to figure out where that punch is going to come from. Has to tell Tony where it's going to come from,
and Tony
has to figure out how he's going to block it. Yeah, Tony's a smart guy, but he's going to take some of these punches.
Yeah.
War Machine get his ass kicked too?
Yes, that becomes that is the other big contention of why whatchamacallit continues to fight. He takes partial blame for himself, but he puts more of the blame on everybody else. While they're fighting, Cap and Bucky are flying away on a jet.
Mm-hmm.
And the Falcon, he's flying after them. And War Machine and Iron Man are right behind him. War Machine's like, "I've got a plan. I'm gonna shoot him out of the sky." And Tony's like, "I'm gonna do it too?" And unbeknownst to anybody else that a targeting computer is not the best thing to rely upon, Falcon is sitting there going in the same direction for a few seconds. War Machine's like, "Fire!" Basically calls out his shot. And Falcon's like, "Oh, wait, what the fuck?" And he moves out of the way, like, lazily dodges to the right. Well, Tony's now firing his. It hits War Machine, who's now free falling to his death. And Falcon's like, oh shit, he tries to fly down and save him, so does Tony, but both do that near miss, and then Rhodes hits the ground. And then that's where that kind of funny moment is that, you know, Iron Man is like talking to him, and he's like, Rhodes, no, you done being got shot. I don't know who did this. Who shot you? It was not. And the creator's like, it was you, Tony. He's like, no, it wasn't me. Who shot you? God damn you, Spider-Man. They're like, Spider-Man's on your side. Shut up, I'm blaming people.
So wait, is Rhodey dead?
He's not dead, but Falcon walks up, and then it's actually a solemn moment if you watch it. You know, I'm being a dick about it, but it's a solid.
Curse you, space monkey!
Like, he's sitting there holding Rhodes, and then Falcon walks up, he's like, yo, man, look, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to go so hard on you, but, you know, I had to dodge. You want to shoot me out of the sky? It was either me or him, you know how it is. And then, like, the guy, like, Tony shoots him, and he falls back on his ass.
Didn't kill him, though,
right? He didn't kill him. He hit him really hard with a concussive shot to the chest. And he's like, you know, it was a funny moment. You know, it actually is a lot more touching. But in my head, I was thinking of more of like, you know, like when you go outside and play with your friends. And
Jerome!
You
know,
you foul someone, but you're like, the ref fouled you, man. It was one-on-one. It was you. No, man, it was the ref. No, dude. It was one-on-one. I saw it happen.
Man, the ref.
And then
they're trying to tear us apart, man.
And then the ref is just like, yo, man, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. And then the guy attacks the ref. Yeah, exactly. But yeah, that's pretty much how it is.
He knocks the ref down. The ref starts crying. Their mom comes out to find out what's going on. And nobody says anything.
Yeah, nobody has an answer. Technically, the Civil War is not going on, but it sort of is going on because Cap's now not a part of the Avengers.
Yes, he'll be back for Infinity Wars. You know
he'll have to be, but
you know what it is. It was just Breton. Tension. No, it's just tension for Infinity Wars. You know,
everyone going to
have Cap be a vigilante with Bucky, and then Iron Man, or he's going to run to people.
Yeah.
All it is just contention until probably... Aren't the Guardians supposed to show up in Infinity Wars?
Yeah, they're supposed to, because they have one of the Infinity Stones.
I don't know if they have one, but they know where one is.
Yeah. But, well,
technically, the merchant guy had it.
Yeah, he did.
And then the Tesseract is one.
So yeah, that's...
That was the first Infinity Stone we ever got introduced to.
Yeah.
But, you know, like... There's three more, then? Because there's five Infinity Stones for the Gauntlet?
I don't know. Yeah. My friend knows it so much better
than
I do. No,
it's one for reality, one for time, one for strength, one gives you, like, super healing, and the other one, I think, can, like, bend reality.
Yeah.
It's literally...
One of them's from Guardians of the Galaxy. That went to the Nova Corps.
Oh, okay. You mean actually from that. I was talking from the
actual
comics.
Figure it out when, I can look it up afterwards.
But I know he's got five,
you know,
and
what?
I know when you have... One, you assess.
Tell us how wrong we were about the Infinity Wars in the comments below.
Exactly.
Thank you so much for watching. Hope you subscribed if you haven't already.
Video's
we'll see you in the next one either way.
You know, it's just. Can you see if we can skip out of this? I mean, we'll keep that ending, but let's see if there's anything that pops up. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
A cutscene.
Okay. Well, thanks for hanging out till the end of the credits.
Yeah.
If you're still here.
Now you can walk out. Refill your popcorn thing like a goof and go home with your free popcorn.
Or,
you pay too much for it.
Or you can go out, get your popcorn, and then go see another movie.
Ooh. Yeah, yeah.
Just don't pay for it. You're already in the movie theater. No one's going to check you.
Yeah.
I've done it.
Criminal activity.
Criminal my ass.
I pay pay me a shit ton of money.
You want me to get how many concessions? Fuck you. I get two tickets.
For a shitty movie,
I deserve
two. See
I
you
got
next
most
time.
Of the riddles. Make that another video.
Yeah.
Man, what's gonna replace?
Let's this? Talk about that after the video. Have a great day, guys. This is the end of another series. Hope you enjoyed it.